falling down tonight, but we're told they will not be closing the roof, so we'll have to make do. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Miami Marlins. Going to be an interesting contrast in styles in this one as one of baseball's hardest throwers goes head-to-head with a top finesse arm. Next, Dan Straley, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan, any thoughts?
Dan Straley's bounced around for a little while, but he's a four-pitch guy. Fastball, curveball, slider, changeup. Not an overpowering pitcher. Needs all four of his pitches. If he has that good changeup, he could be really tough.
Now at the plate, Malik Smith. He'll get us started in this one under the lights.
Left fielder, Malik Smith.
Here's the first pitch to him. And the first pitch of the ball game here is taken for a called strike one. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
There's a called strike on a changeup. Not a particularly good one. That changeup up in the zone like this oftentimes gets hit very hard. Was able to get away with it that time, but if he's going to be successful, he's going to need to get that changeup down in the zone around the knees.
Count is 1-2 now. The 1-2. Is looked at for ball number two.
Kind of pitching him backwards in this AB. Soft stuff early. Then those last two were fastballs trying to get it right by him.
Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Oh, and a nice changeup that time gets him to swing right through it as the leadoff man is down on strikes to open up the ball game. Time now for a look at the Rays starting nine. What's the key for them tonight, Hero?
Well, Maddie, we know this is a pitcher's park. The numbers bear it out. Look for the managers to play a part in this one. Hopefully the guys listened in the hitters' meeting. They're going to stay up the middle, big part of the yard. But when they get on, look for some wheels in motion, some execution, trying to manufacture some runs. I think that's how this lineup will play it out.
First pitch coming. Here it is. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is James Kingsley.
Dan, I know I was an offensive player, but I'm okay being a pitcher's umpire. If you're going to consistently pound that outer half, James Kingsley's usually going to give it to you.
Hey, listen, there's a reason why the pitchers throughout the league, they call him the king of the hill. You move the ball a little bit off the strike zone, he's not afraid to put that arm up. He's a very good pitcher's umpire.
Now the 1-1 pitch. There's a low changeup that's laid off. Bases are empty, one man out. Two balls and two strikes to Duffy. Here's a fly ball now headed out to Maven in center. And that's out number two.
Batting third, center fielder, Devin Kiermaier.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Kevin Kiermaier. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike. Just starting things out here in South Florida. And that one just missed outside. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Brinson is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Down in order go the Rays. And now the Marlins will have a crack at things. No score. Chris Archer will be the starter for the Rays in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Chris Archer, one of the premier pitchers in baseball. When he's good, he's nearly unhittable. Great fastball with movement. Slider probably his best pitch, and the changeup has been much better recently. If Chris Archer brings his A game, it's going to be a long night for the hitters.
Leading off ready now, Marlins. Cameron Maybin. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Maybin.
First pitch of the at-bat. Missed with a slider. The 1-0 misses off the plate. Maybin, who sometimes goes by the nickname Slim, who was selected in the first round back in 2005.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on a superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go into high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
Now the 2-1. Shoots this one over to first. Home scoops it up. They'll take it to the bag himself, and the leadoff man is gone here to start the home first. We have a moment here in Miami to take a look at the Marlins' starting lineup. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Well, I really like what Justin Bourne does for this team. He's one of those guys you want at the plate in those big game-defining moments. He's such a clutch hitter. I love watching him in those situations, and hopefully we'll have that in this game as well.
Ready now for the Marlins, Martin Prado, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Looking at a fastball for a strike on the corner. One out, nobody on. One and one, the count to Martin Prado.
That's the kind of pitch that reminds me of many reasons why I wasn't a very good hitter. This thing was inside and coming in hot, and he just gave a stone cold take. I'm bailing out of the way if I'm in the box, no doubt about it.
Fouled away. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Here now the 2-2. Gets him looking, strike three.
Great spot on that 2-2 fastball. You can't place it on the inside corner any better than that. And as a hitter, there's just not a whole lot you can do with that unless you're looking for it and time it just right. Love seeing a guy that can work the inside with his fastball.
Here's Starlin Castro as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. Head-to-head against Chris Archer, he's got 8 hits in 20 at-bats. He also has 1 home run. The 1-0 home. Finds the zone, strike one.
That's a real good job of going back-to-back fastballs right there. Most of the time, a hitter will see a fastball in the inside half of the plate, and they'll just think, well, this pitcher's going to go back on the outside. But when you double up like he did right there, it sends a message to the hitter that you're not afraid to throw in that inner half of the plate.
The count now at 2-1. Hitter's count now. Here's the 2-1. And he'll stay alive here, but just barely as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. The 2-2 is looked at for ball three.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Line drive to left. This is right to him in left as he hardly has to move as he handles it for the final out. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. Still no score. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Carlos Gomez. He'll start things out in the top half of the second.
We're moving right along into this one as we head into the late innings. Listen, if you want to score, you got to have to bunch some hits together, and they haven't been able to do that so far. So hopefully this leadoff guy, this will be the right guy at the right spot to get something going.
Swing and a miss on the slider, nothing and one. Well, fans of the art of pitching are in for a treat. One of the game's big-time flamethrowers faces a top craftsman here today.
And you're going to see two different mindsets from both offenses, Dan. Facing the power guy, he's going to come at you. He's going to pitch to his strengths and not your weakness. And on the flip side, the finesse guy is going to try and keep everyone off balance. And I want to see what off-speed pitch he has working.
You know, Dero, that's one of the beautiful things about the game of baseball. Good pitchers come in all different shapes and sizes, and they come with all different type of weapons. We're going to see one flamethrower and one guy that throws below the speed limit.
2-1 the count. And the pitch on 2-1. And he lays off the circle change here as he moves into the driver's seat, 3-1. Brad Miller will be next. Hard on the ground towards short. Riddle has it cleanly. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
All right, here's the defensive alignment for the Miami Marlins. Hey, let's focus on Cameron Maybin in the outfield. One of the more dynamic outfielders in our sport. He's able to cover a ton of ground, gap to gap. I almost feel like he's playing left center to right center. He's not playing center field. He's got it all covered, bailing the other guys out, and not shabby with the offensive tool either.
Up next for the Rays, Brad Miller. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Nowhere close with the fastball to begin the at-bat. It's ball one. And this one's on the inside corner, 1-1. Called strike, and he's behind 1-2. The 1-2. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Lifted down the line in left. Prado is in pursuit. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning.
Batting six, the catcher number 40, Wilson Ramos.
Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. Batter pitcher numbers against Dan Straley. He's just 1-for-6. Here's the first pitch to him. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Now the 1-0 is taken for ball two. Tried to hold back, but this is popped up. Dives, and he makes the catch. How about that for an exclamation point to the end of the inning? That's as good a play as you're going to see a second baseman make, and he does it to end the inning through an inning and a half. No score on MLB Network. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Justin Bour, will stand in against Chris Archer to get the inning underway.
Not sure if this is a powerhouse pitching performance by both teams or bad hitting, but as we're moving late into this one, it's about time somebody put something together to try to score a run.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Smith in pursuit. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
All right, let's take a look at the Tampa Bay Rays on defense. And let's focus on Wilson Ramos. He's an absolute brick wall behind the plate. And if you miss middle over the heart of the plate, he could turn it around with a three-run bomb.
Up next from Miami, JT Realmuto. First offering on its way. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's one and one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Here's the pitch. And he wouldn't have made contact with that one with an oar. It's 2-2. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Gomez has a read on it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now.
Batting fifth, right fielder, Lewis Brinson.
Up next from Miami, Lewis Brinson will try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And that slider's almost in the dirt. Bottom of the second here with no score. Two balls, no strikes to the Miami center fielder.
That was a non-competitive pitch right there, and he finds himself behind 2-0 in this situation. He's going to have to locate something down the zone, get himself back in this count.
And he gets the call that time for strike number one. And a pretty good take there on the slider down. It's ball three.
You know, when you haven't gotten a guy on base yet in the entire game, a three-ball count kind of feels like a little mini rally. Let's see if he can get on.
The 3-1 pitch. Full count now, 3-2. Line towards center field. A dive, but it's off his glove.
Well, this was a good start for the pitcher. First five guys, five up, five down, but the number six hitter proved to be a little bit more difficult, and that's a bullet hit.
Yeah, absolutely right there, Dan. Just a nice AB by the six-hole guy after watching his first five brethren take a seat.
In now, Brian Anderson. As the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. One strike now from Archer. Popped him up. Prone is there for it. And that retires the side. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are tied 0-0. Here's C.J. Cron now. He's the number seven hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first six guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Here's the first pitch to him. takes a high fastball for a strike.
He looks really strong here early in this game, and that fastball is a good example. Put that thing in a great spot and right where he wanted it.
Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. Two balls and a strike to C.J. Cron. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1. Adani Echevarria waits on deck. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Here's Echevarria now. Batter pitcher numbers against Dan Straley. He's 1-for-4. First pitch of the at-bat. He's running. It swung on and missed the throw. The tag by Castro, and he's out at second base.
Well, he showed a lot of patience to work out that walk, but it got erased pretty quickly. Always hate to give outs away on the base pass, especially when you've gotten on base for free.
Third inning, no score to this point. Swing and a soft liner, and the Rays are in the hit column.
Batting ninth, the pitcher number 22.
Denard Span will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning.
Denard Span.
And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. From the belt, kicks and deals, and it's fouled away. Working for the punch out and the offering. Pitch is popped up. Anderson waits on it. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Now batting, left fielder, Alex Smith.
Digging in for his second at bat, Malik Smith. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. First offering on its way. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Two out with the man at first. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. Fastball, and he swings through it to fall behind.
So far in this game, he's the only guy in the lineup that's gone down on strikes.
Yeah, and he might strike out for a second time right here.
The 1-2. This is flared out towards second. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. One left for Tampa. Home half of the third coming up. No score.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Rays, number 46, Jose Alvarado.
Stepping in, JT Little. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Leading off for the Marlins, the shortstop, JT Little.
He's set. Here it comes. Swing and a high pop-up toward the stands behind third. Duffy will back up and put this one way just past the dugout for the first down.
Every pitcher loves to get quick outs, right? How about that? One pitch, one out, a pop-up to start the inning.
Scott Van Slyke will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number five, Scott Van Slyke.
Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. The 1-0. Here's Echevarria at shortstop. Throw gets him, two down.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner that time, and that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over it.
Here's Cameron Maben now. First pitch on its way. Thought he had the inside corner that time, but it missed for ball one. Seared down the first baseline, but a foul ball, one and one. The 1-1 misses, ball two. Bottom of inning number three, nothing, nothing our score. Now a curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1. The 3-1. And this one misses inside, a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count, and the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind an account like that, though.
Martin Prado now has got a chance to end this one and send these fans home happy if he can get a ball deep enough into the gap. Now we'll step off and fire to the bag. And he just manages to get his hand in. First delivery to him on the way. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike.
Great job of getting back in the zone with a hard fastball after the walk. I think he might have let a little frustration out with that pitch.
The 0-1, and there he goes towards second, hit in the air down the right field line, and he might have done it. Can they score that runner from first? And the Marlins have done it. They walk off a winner.
Hey, this game looked like it was going to be one of those wild ones right from the beginning. But when you can win this thing in walk-off fashion, what a way to win a ball game. A walk-off win?
Well, we watched a really solid starting pitching performance, kept the opposition at bay, and as a result, he's our top player of the game.
Well, you know he wants that one pitch back that led to the lone hit, but it was pretty awesome watching him do his thing. He had guys off balance and flailing at the plate all game long, so he really was the story.
that one run held up tonight, 1-0 the final. The Miami Marlins led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Dan Straley takes home the win. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and the entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network. Have a good night, everybody.